वन्नेतुभिस्सीदसादनम् ओम सहनावतु सहनोभुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांतिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं सो वी आर सीइंग द टेंथ मंत्र भाष्यम सह शांत संकल्प दट अप टू दट वी हैव सीन नेक्स्ट वी विल से सुमनाः प्रसन्न मनाश्च यथा स्यात् वीतमन्युः विगत रोषश्च गौतमो मम पिता माभि मां प्रति हे मृत्यो So that is the end of the first half of the mantra. Sumanaha means prasanna manaha. Shanta sankalpaha means all agitations are gone. Sumanaha means in the place of agitation now a happiness comes. Prasannata will come. A composure will come into the mind of my father. What is the reason for this composure? You see, my son is a very good boy. He has studied well, even such a small age, his love for dharma is remarkable, and he wanted to keep my truthfulness. For that purpose, he went to Yamadharma Raja, and Yama being, though he is a Mrityu Devata, at the same time he is a Dharma Devata also. Very interesting thing, he is not only Mrityu Devata, but Dharma Devata. Therefore, Dharma Rakshati Rakshitaha, this is a very standard statement. So this is from Mahabharata, Dharma Rakshati Rakshitaha. So Dharmaraja will protect the boy because the boy has gone to him to protect Dharma. I sent him to protect Dharma. And that being, he being Dharma Devata, he will protect the boy. And he will surely send my boy back to me. Just because I sent him to him, he will not keep him with him. So keeping with him means Mrityu Ityarthaha. So the boy will be taken care of, no harm will come to him. This type of prasannata will rule in his mind. That is prasanna manaha. Yatha syat. How he becomes like that? Please bless him that way. That is one varam. Yatha syat. Then vetamanyuhu. Vigata roshascha. If any grievance is there, my son has really pushed the things too far. That type of grievance, if anything is there in his mind, that also should go away. So that way my father should become Gautamaha. Gautamaha is Mama Pita. Ma Abhi Mrityo. These are the words. Ma is Mam. Abhi means Prati, towards me. He Mrityo. So towards me, my father should not have any grievance. Vetamanyuhu means grievance is gone. Grievance towards him, ma abhi vetamanyuhu. Towards me, grievance is not there. So that way, this is the varam. Next we will say, kincha tvatprasrushtam tvayavinirmuktam preshitam gruham prati maam abhivadet प्रतीतो लब्ध स्मृति ही स एवायं पुत्रः ममागतः इत्येवं प्रत्यभिजानन् इत्यर्थः किंच किंच अंटे इन एडिशन टू दैट त्वत्प्रसृष्टम् त्वया प्रसृष्टम् दैट इज द मीनिंग सो त्वया प्रसृष्टम् मीन्स विनिर्मुक्तम् रिलीज्ड बाय यू So it is like going to the jaws of the death and coming back, unharmed that way. So you will send me back. That is also implied in the varam. Tvaya vinirmuktam. Vinirmuktam means graham preshitam. Okay, boy, you, dear boy, you go back to your house. Like that you will send me back. So when I go back, maam prati abhivadet, when I reach the house, my father, He approaches me and speaks me in kind words. Abhivadet. Maam abhivadet. Maam means towards me. Maam abhi. Maam abhimukhi krutya. That means towards me. Pratitaha. Vadet is there. Pratitaha is there. Pratitaha means labdha smrutihi. he remembers me as his own son. Sa evayam putraha mama agataha. It is not some ghost or any such thing. The same boy whom I have sent from here, he alone came in flesh and blood. So the same boy has returned to me. Ityevam pratyabhijanan. That way he will recognize me. Pratyabhijanan means, pratyabhijna means a person we have seen long back and again we see him. So that is what is called pratyabhijna, recognition. The type of recognition he will have towards me. Ityarthaha. Next. Etat prayojanam. Trayanam varanam. Prathama madhyam urune. Prarthayeyam. Yat pituh paritoshanam. So in the mantra you have etat prayanam prathamam varam urune. Etat means this. This means this prayojanam, this purpose. This purpose, what is the purpose? Pituhu paritoshanam. Yet pituhu paritoshanam etat. So father becoming happy in every respect. So his sankal agitations are gone, prasannata has returned. After some time I will go back to him, he will recognize me and he will not have any grievance towards me. The whole lot is covered. So the father is finally one word, paritoshanam, paritaha toshanam. In every respect he is happy. This happiness of the father. Another word for it is pituhu saumanasyam. We will come across that word later. So father having a sumanastvam, his mind being calm and quiet and happy. That is the prathamam varam, prathamam adhyam varam, the first vara, first among the three. So trayanam varanam madhye prathamam adhyam varam vrune, aham prarthayeyam. This is what I am asking for. This is what I am requesting for. Prarthayeyam. Prarthaye. Prarthayeyam. Prarthayeva. Prarthayema. Like that. So, Uttama Purusha Ekavachanam. I am requesting for it. 11th mantra. Yatha purastad bhavita pratitaha. Auddalaki raru nirma prasrushtaha. सुखगुम रात्रि सीता वीतमन्युहु त्वाम ददृशिवाम मृत्यु मुखात्र मुक्तम यथा पुरस्ताद भविता प्रतीतः औद्दालकी राजु निर्मत्र सृष्टः सुखगुम रात्रि सीता वीतमन्युः त्वाम ददृशिवान् मृत्युमुखात्र मुक्तम्. So this is the statement of मृत्युदेवता. मृत्युः वाचा. When Nachiketa told like that, मृत्यु is responding. He says, yes, I am giving you that, I am granting your request. That is what he is going to say. So he is telling like this. Yatha purastat pratitaha tatha bhavita. Yatha is there, so tatha will come. Purastat means earlier. Pratitaha bhavita. Pratitaha means vishvastaha. Having confidence. Having recognized as the same old guy. Then he will gain confidence. There is no reason to worry about his identity and all that. So no such problems will be there. Earlier he was treating you with all love and affection. The same way he will continue to treat you after going from me back to the house also. Yatha purastad bhavita pratitaha. Who? Your father. So now that father is referred by two more words. So Vajasravaha, one word, Gautamaha is gone. Vajasravaha is a title for him. He has done a lot of annadanam, etc. Gautama is Gotrapatyam. Gautama Gotra Udbhavaha. Now, two more interesting words. Auddalakihi, Arunihi. So, Bhashyakara will explain it. There I will point it out. What is the significance of that? So, Uddalaka has got something to do with him. Aruna also has got something to do with him. We will see that. Then, Matrasrushtaha, your father, who is Uddalaki and Aruni, He will recognize you as his own son. He will receive you. Mat prasrushtaha. I will send you back to him. So he will receive you and recognize you. That is over. Then in the meanwhile, before you go, some time it will take, you know. So a few days may elapse before the boy again goes to his father and all that. In the meanwhile, he may not sleep. So he is telling he will sleep happily. Sukham ratrihi shayita. You see, if your mind is very agitated, you will not be able to sleep properly. So, if you go to the doctor and tell, I am not able to sleep in the night, the doctor will ask, why, are there many mosquitoes or what? No, mosquitoes is not the reason. Then there must be something in the mind. Otherwise, because these are the two reasons why the fellow is unable to sleep. If it is mosquitoes is ruled out, then the agitation of the mind is left. Once Dhritarashtra Maharaja was not able to sleep. In Mahabharatam you come across this thing. So 10 o'clock he tries to sleep, no sleep. 11 it is, no sleep. 12 it is, no sleep. Then he calls the guard, that Dwarapalaka, and tells him, I am unable to sleep, go and bring Vidura. Vidura was nicely sleeping. So this guard goes and wakes up Vidura. Vidura comes, what is the matter? I am unable to sleep. Then he says, when Rajoguna is more, then the mind will be in total agitated situation. In that situation, you will not be able to sleep. So the Rajogunam has to be replaced with a Sattvaguna. Then you will be able to sleep. Then Dhritarashtra says, okay, then you replace the Rajoguna with Sattvaguna. Then Vidura says, we will do prarthana towards Sanat Sujata. Sanat Sujata is a rishi. So we will do prarthana to him. And he will come to us, and he is a yogi, Mahayogi. So by our prarthana he will listen to it, and he will come by Akash Marga, and he will give you a piece of advice. He can do that, I will not be able to do that. So both of them do prarthana towards Sanat Sujata Maharshi. He comes, and he teaches some Vedanta to Dhritarashtra Maharaja. Then he goes to sleep. After listening to that Rajoguna is replaced by Sattvaguna, and he goes to sleep. So what I remembered is, so in the night time if a person is unable to sleep because of agitation, the best medicine is you read a little Vedanta, you will be able to sleep. That is the best possible medicine. Sukhagam ratrihi shayita, your father will nicely sleep in the night. Why? Vetamanyuhu, this grievance, agitation, etc. towards you, they will all go away. I will see that they go away. Also, Tvam Dadrushivan, he is going to see you. In what situation? Mrityu mukhat pramuktam. Snatched away from the jaws of death. Or escaped from the jaws of death. I am death, you have come to me and I am going to send you back. So mrityu mukhat pramuktam tvam dadrushivan. Will see bhashyam. Yatha buddhihi tvai purastat purvamasit स्नेह समन्विता पितुस्तवा भविता प्रीति समन्विता तव पिता तथैव प्रतीतः प्रतीतवान् सं औद्दालकिः. सो यथा मीन्स इन विच एवर फैशन, पुरस्तात् मीन्स पूर्वम एर्लियर, त्वयि बुद्धिः आसीत्, his mind was inclined towards you. Earlier it was inclined towards you with a lot of affection and love. Tatha means same way. Yatha is there, so tatha is taken. Sneha samanvita bhavita. Tava pituhu manaha sneha samanvita bhavata bhavita. Manaha buddhihi. So your father's buddhi or mind will be same way, like it was earlier. How? Sneha samanvita, filled with love and affection towards you. Kriti samanvita stava pita. So earlier your father was having lot of affection towards you, kriti. He will continue to be the same way. Tathaiva, in the same way. Pratitaha. Pratitaha means pratitavan. Means having vishwasam, vishwastaha. He will believe in you. This same pratitaha came in the earlier mantra also. Earlier, same it is now repeated. because he should not be under the impression that a pisachar, a ghost has come back to his house. That's why that word pratitaha is repeated. So pratitavan, son. Your father will recognize you as his own son. No problem in that account. Then that father's name is given as Auddalakihi. Here there are two words, Auddalakihi Arunahi. Both refer to his father, like Dasharathihi. When you say Dasharathihi, it means the son of Dasharatha. So Dasharathihi Ramaha, when you say, that Rama's father is given by the word Dasharatha. So similarly, this Nachiketa's father is being referred to. He is referred to as Uddalakihi. So he might be the son of Uddalaka. That is one possibility. Arunihi is also there. Then he is the son of Aruna. How it is possible? Two fathers are not possible. Two mothers are possible, not two fathers. So what Bhashyakara are doing is, Swarthe Prachayam is also there. That means, Balaha is a word is there. Swarthe Ka Prachayam. Bala plus Ka. Bala Kaha you will get. So a Prachayam has come. Generally a Prachayam will improve upon the meaning. It will change the meaning or it will improve upon the meaning. But in this case, there is no change or improvement in the meaning. The meaning remains as such. So such a situation is called Swarthe Ka Prachayaha. In the same way, Uddalaka is the fellow. He is Uddalaka only. No change, is not the son of Uddalaka, etc. No such meaning. Uddalakaha eva Auddalakihi. Uddalaka himself is he. It can happen in two ways. One is the son of that meaning, or the same meaning, Swarthe. Here he says, Bhashyakara says, it is the same, Uddalakihi eva, Uddalakaha eva, Auddalakihi, Swarthe Prachayam. That way you have to tell. Otherwise, you cannot account for Uddalaka and Aruna, two fathers you cannot account for. That is one way. So once you have taken care of Uddalaka thing, Uddalaka eva Uddalakihi, then you are free to use this son of in the second word. Arunihi is there. So Aruna is the name of a rishi. His son is Nachiketa's father. Okay? So Aruna plus E, Adi Vruddhi. So A becomes A, Arunihi. That is how Bhashyakara is explaining. So you say that Arunasya Apatyam Arunihi. So Arunasya means a rishi by name Aruna. His son, Apatyam is son. His son becomes Arunihi. So Uddalaka eva Uddalakihi Arunasya Apatyam. That is one way. How do you know Uddalaka eva Uddalakihi Arunasya Apatyam? How do you know? I don't know. We have to somehow interpret it. That's why one possibility is that. If you don't like it, if you want to have both as a son of Uddalakasya Apatyam Uddalakihi Arunasya Apatyam Arunihi, you want to have that way? Okay, you have that way also. In that case, what you have to do is, he is originally the son of one of them, and then he has been adopted by the other fellow. That way you have to answer. There is no other way. So that possibility also can be taken. So he is telling that. We'll say that. Dvyamushyayanova. So this amushyayanaha is an interesting word. Amushya means, of so-and-so, a very well-known person is there. When you are referring to a well-known person, we will say, of so-and-so. That so-and-so has to be replaced by appropriate name. In general, any well-known person is referred to as, he is the son of so-and-so, in English. In Sanskrit, amushya putraha. Amushya means of so-and-so. That amushya you have to replace with appropriate name. It can be Uddalaka, it can be Aruna, it can be Dasharatha, anything can come in the place of Amushya. That becomes a specific name. In general, when we say Amushya Putraha, so Amushya Putraha, it becomes Amushyayanaha. But now it is not one Amushya, there are two Amushyas. He is the son of two fathers. He is originally the son of one father, and then he went for adoption. This is what is called Dattata, you must be knowing it. So when the fellow is adopted, there is a Vedic rite, so So they will perform that ritual and the fellow becomes the son of somebody, some other father. So that such a fellow is called Dvyamushyayana. There are two seven souls. Both of them are fathers to this fellow. So he becomes Dvyamushyayana. So he becomes the son of Udalaki as well as Aruna. Then whose original son and whose adopted son, that again remains left to your imagination. So only this much information we can get from the words there. Dvyamushyayano va. So that is about Nachiketa's father. Now he has got four names by now. Anyway, next. Matra srushtaha mayanujnyatasam itara apiratrihi sukham prasannamanaha shayita swatta veta manyuhu vigata manyushcha bhavita syat vam putram dadrishivam drushtavam saha mrityumukhat mrityugocharat pramuktam santam. So that the father of Nachiketa, he will be happy. He will not have any reason for unhappiness. Because mat prasrushtaha, sent by me. That means maya anujnyataha. I will give permission to you to go back. Maya anujnyatasam, you will go back. And he will receive you and he will have confidence upon you. And then itaraha api ratrihi sukham shayita. Tonight itself he will sleep happily because I will send you back. Not only tonight, in future life also, he will not have any reason for unhappiness. As long as he lives, he will live peacefully and happily. He will sleep. So the symbol for saying, we say it like this, I slept happily by keeping my hand on my heart. That is what we say. So that means my mind is very peaceful. That is a symbol for peace of mind. So in that sense it is used. Otherwise it doesn't matter whether he sleeps a little less or more. So he will have peace of mind. That is what Nachiketa asked for and that is what Yamadharma Raja is giving. So Ratrihi Shayita, it is a poetic way of putting it. He will sleep happily. Sukham Shayita. Prasanna Manaha Shayita. With a composed mind he will be able to sleep. Swapta. Shayita means swapta. So, Shayana Dhatu gives the word Shayita. Swapa Dhatu gives the word Swapita. It is Aswapta. Veta Manyuhu, it is again repeated. So, it is come already in the earlier mantra also. So, Yama is assuring him. He asked, Veta Manyuhu he should become. So, Yama says, yes, he will become Veta Manyuhu. Vigata Manyuscha Bhavita Syat. He does become Vigata Manyu. That means all grievances are removed completely. Because Tvam Putram Dadrushivan. Dadrushivan is a Vaidika Prayogam. Corresponding Laukika Prayoga is a Drashtavan. You cannot say Dadrushivan because that is a Vedic language only. In our normal Laukika Sanskrit you have to say Drashtavan. So he is going to see his son. Already Drashtavan is a Vartamana. So Samipyam. He is going to see. But then it will not be delayed. I will send you soon enough. Therefore, it is as good as he has already seen. So, drushtavan, saha, your father. How? Mrityumukhat pramuktam santam. Mrityugocharat pramuktam santam. Mukha is the mouth. It is not that Yamadharma Raja is going to put him in his mouth and crush under the jasi. It is not that. So, mrityugocharat pramuktam. He is going to be subjected to death. Gocharatvam is being subjected to. So he is going to be dead because he is now taken over by Yamadharma Raja. From such a situation he is released. Mrityu gocharat pramuktam. Mrityu vishayat pramuktam ityartha. From the jurisdiction of death he comes out. So that is how you have to understand that word. Then we will go for the 13th mantra. स्वर्गे लोके न भयं किंच नास्ति न तत्रत्वं न जरया बिभेति उभे तीर्त्वा शनाया पिपासे शोकातिगो मोदते स्वर्गलोके स्वर्गे लोके न भयं किंच नास्ति न तत्रत्वं न जरया बिभेति उभे तीर्त्वा शनाया पिपासे शोकातिगो मोदते स्वर्गलोके स्वर्गे लोके न भयं किंचन अस्ति न तत्र त्वं न जरया बिभेति उभे तीर्त्वा अशनाया पिपासे शोकातिगः मोदते स्वर्गलोके. नौ नचिकेता हैज टू आस्क फॉर द सेकंड वरम. दैट्स व्हाई भाष्यकार सेज नचिकेता उवाच. नचिकेताः उवाच. सो नचिकेतस इज टॉकिंग. This mantra is talked by Nachiketa. He is going to ask for a varam which will help the total mankind. Now is a very interesting boy. That social concept, that love for the society and other people, swayam tirtva paramstarayati. He crosses this ocean of samsara himself and then helps others to cross. This attitude you can find in that boy. He wanted the first varam to be allotted to his family. There is no particular varam for himself. So family is taken care of, I am taken care of. Society is taken care of, I am taken care of. Mankind is taken care of, I am taken care of. This is the approach. Whereas a swartha purushaha, a very selfish fellow, when my stomach is full, the whole world is happy. That is how he thinks. When I am happy, the whole world is supposed to be happy. When I am unhappy, then the whole world is unhappy. So this is the entirely opposite approach. So he is not going to ask for a varam for himself. Yamadharma Raja says, you ask a boon for yourself. Then he says, no, I don't want. No, I will give you an extra boon. Even then I don't want. Personally, I don't want anything. So for my family, for my father, mother, etc., one varam. The society in which I live, for that, one varam. And for the posterity, for the sake of knowledge, that rishidhanam, the knowledge is received from the rishis and given to the society. So, for that sake, one varam. That's all. No varam for himself. Even after Yama tells him, you take a varam for yourself, he refuses. So, he is now going to ask for a varam which will help people gain svargalokam. Because, once again in Veda, we divide people into two categories. One is ragis and the other is viragis. Ragi means he wants to enjoy some pleasures. But at the same time, he doesn't want to cross the limits of dharma. That is what is called a ragi. We are not talking about a person who wants to enjoy by hook or crook. Such a person is not considered for the shastram. He is a papi. He is another word used for him is he is a pamaraha. So we are not talking about him. He will have a wrong, he will do papam and he will have to enjoy the bitter fruits of the papam. We are talking about a viveki, yet a ragi. He has got viveka, this much vivekam, namely I should not transgress dharma for the sake of my personal benefit. But if without transgressing dharma, if it is possible to gain some personal benefit, I want it. I want it, indeed I want it. Such a person is ragi, he is addressed. And he is advised to undertake certain karmas which will fetch him the desired results. So the society consists of this category of people to a large extent. So they have to be addressed. Their need, their spiritual need has to be addressed. So Shruti is addressing their spiritual need in the form of a second desire. Asked by Nachiketa from Yamadharma Raja. So the desire is about Svargalokam. People have got this innate desire to enjoy carnal pleasures. You just can't wish them away. Everybody has got this desire for these pleasures. So what all we have to see that the fellow does not cross dharma for the sake of the desires. So you have to provide an opportunity within the dharma for the desires to be fulfilled. It is like our Deepavali. Everybody has got an instinct of destroying something or the other. Therefore, you don't go on destroying people's houses and buses and other things every day. On Deepavali day, for 1 hour, you destroy some of these crackers. Some vinasham you do and be happy. If you want to do again some more vinasham, you wait for 1 year again on Deepavali day. On which day that the Jagan Mata has killed a rakshasa, narakasura, you have some fun. So that way you have, for fun also, Shastra gives abhyanujna. It's not that I will have fun whenever I want fun. No. It's not like at the drop of a hat you go and engage a party. No, not that way. You have a party. Party also is allowed in Vedam. But there must be an occasion. So Ekadashi you keep fast. Dwadashi you will have a feast. So like that it is also abhyanujna is there. So within the dharma, you have a scope for enjoyment and that is being taken care of. Because society has ragis. Swarge loke bhayam kinchana na asti. Hey Yamadharma Raja, I understand this is all heard, anushrivika it is. Which is only heard, we don't know about it. So Nachiketa says, in swarga there is no bhayam. That is what Shruti says. And therefore we go by the words of the Shruti. There is no bhayam in Shruti. Not only that, he says, he is a very shrewd boy, he is telling, natatratvam, you are not there. In our bhuloka, you play havoc with people's lives. You are there everywhere. You are there every second. Whereas in swargam, your jurisdiction will not work there. In Telugu we say, ni atala swargamlo sagavu. That is how we say in Telugu. So, you cannot wield your power in Svarga. Suppose you want to take away one fellow from Bhuloka, you can do it in a jiffy. Whereas if you want to take away a person from Svarga, no, you will not be able to do that. That means, this mrityu, this fear of death, which constantly haunts people in the Bhulokam, is totally absent in the Svargalokam. Natatratvam, najaraya bibheti. Here, in addition to mrityu, there is one more thing, that is called jara. It is also called mrityu sarathihi. First sarathi comes, then the yajamani, the owner comes. First driver comes, then the owner comes, like that. So jara is the old age, is the sarathi. And behind him, there is mrityu. So you will not be able to touch them in swarga, and this jara, your sarathi, also will not be able to touch them in swarga. Therefore, in swarga, they are called Tridashas. The people, Devatas, they have got a name, Tridasha. Tridasha means his age is 30 years all the time. It is like the age of some of our cine stars, like Madhuri Dixit, etc. Their age is permanently 22 only. It never crosses 22 or 23. It will never touch 30. Whereas Devatas are a bit more considerate. Their age is permanently 30. It never crosses 30. That means they are permanently young. Jara is not going to bother them. So that is how he describes Svargalokam. This is the description of Nachiketa. Then, in this loka we have two problems. Ashanaya and Pipasa. Ashanaya means Ashitum Ichha, the desire to eat. So in another 1 hour, less than 1 hour, we will go for lunch. Because there is a desire to eat. And unless you fulfill that basic fundamental desire, you will not be able to survive. And pipasa, patum icha. These are called natural desires. Desires are of two kinds, natural desires and man-made desires. For natural desires, solutions are also natural. So there is hunger here, there is food outside. So Bhagavan said it is Ishvara Srishti. Hunger is Ishvara Srishti. Food is Ishvara Srishti. So Ishvara has created hunger. He takes care of the hunger, the solution also. Similarly, pipasa, patum icha, the desire to drink water. So, that is pipasa, thirst. These two are a problem for a human being in Bhuloka. Because wherever he goes, suppose we go to picnic, two things we have to carry with us. One is a carrier containing food for the lunch. and the second is a bottle of water. Without these two, you cannot step outside the house. These two you have to carry, because Asanaya and Pipasa, they come along with you wherever you go. So whereas in Swarga, you need not bother that way. There people, they will, devatas will not have Asanaya and Pipasa. They will not be suffering from these two. In fact, this Asanaya, the desire, this hunger, is described as a disease. So, Shankara says in one place, Kshudvyadhishcha nivariyatam. Kshudvyadhishcha chikitsyatam. In Sadhana Panchakam he says, Kshudvyadhihi. Disease called Kshut chikitsyatam. It has to be cured. Chikitsa is giving medicine is called chikitsa. Therefore, Kshut is a disease. And the medicine for that is a food. So you have to take food as though it is a medicine. You should not take food as if it is bhoga. For example, we take medicine, some tablets people will be taking. Everybody takes whenever it is needed. So we don't take tablet as if it is a tiffin or nasta, etc. We don't take bhoga buddhi, we don't take tablet. Tablet we take because the body has to be maintained. That's why we take tablet. Similarly, a sadhu, this is sadhana panchakam is meant for sadhus. So a sadhu is supposed to take food as if it is a medicine, vasadhi rupena, bhojana sevanam. It is really a medicine only. Because if you take a medicine, it cures a distortion in the body, an aberration in the body, and the body becomes normal. Similarly, the hunger is an aberration in the body. You take appropriate food and it cures the aberration and the body becomes normal. I tell you, people get diseases by eating more than required. There is no other thing. Just you go on eating all unnecessary things and at every occasion without any meaning and get disease. If you control food intake, just required amount of food only you take, already whatever food you are taking is nearly 50% more than required for the body. So that much protein, that much carbohydrates we don't need. But still we go on taking. So if you control them, then most of the diseases can be kept at bay. This is understood. So this is a very good thing which we learn from Vedanta. Kshudvyadhishcha chikitsyatam. Anyway, that is out of the way. So asanaya pipasya are not there in swargam. That is the point. Shokatigaha. Some people, they are well taken care of with reference to food and water. For example, in the ashram, we don't have the problem of asanaya and pipasa. But then, even then a person may not be able to live peacefully because his mind is agitated. Shoka is there in the mind. He has got enough food in the house and good water is there, yet he is unhappy means what? He is unhappy, something is wrong in the mind. That is the shoka. So in Swargam, this manasika vyadhi, that mental problems, they are also absent. So a person in Swargaloka, he really enjoys. He is giving introduction for this Swargaloka. And he is going to ask him, you give me vidya which helps people to reach such a loka so that I will teach that vidya in the world and they will be able to go to Swargaloka whenever they, whosoever wants that type of a phalam. That is the introduction. So a very shrewd boy, he puts it in a wonderful way. Now we will see the bhashyam. Swarge loke rogadi nimittam bhayam kinchana kinchidapi nasti. So in the Swargaloka, bhayam nasti. Bhayam means what? A fear of roga or adi accidents, etc. Whatever adi siddhena. So that type of bhayam is absent there. Kinchidapi nasti. Leshamapi nasti. Next. Nacha tatra tvam mrutyo sahasa prabhavasi. So, he mrutyotvam is there in the mantra. Therefore, Bhashyakara has put an address to Sambodhana. He mrutyotvam is there, therefore it requires a Sambodhana. So, he mrutyu, there you will not be able to act so easily and freely, na prabhavasi. That type of samarthyam you will not have. You are not allowed there so easily as you do in the case of bhuloka. So, na prabhavasi. You are not able to show your power there so easily. Next. Ataha जरया युक्तः इहलोकवत् त्वत्तो न बिभेति कुतश्चित्तत्र सो तत्र मीन्स स्वर्गलोके कुतश्चित् न बिभेति द फेलो इज नॉट अफ्रेड ऑफ एनीथिंग फॉर एग्जांपल हियर इह जरया युक्तः इहलोकवत् इन दिस श्लोक the persons are afflicted by jara. Jara is old age. It is a fundamental human problem. So it is there for all. That type of fundamental problem is totally absent there. Because jara is absent, therefore you also cannot wield your power there. It is all apekshika. As long as the fellow is in swarga by virtue of his punyam, he is away from all these problems. But once the punyam is over, he has to come back to this bhuloka, where all problems will be there. So this description, it serves two purposes. It glorifies a swargam. At the same time, it tells that it is not a permanent solution for the problems. It is not a permanent solution. That is also implied in all these descriptions, because the fellow will come back anyway. Bhashyam. Kincha ubhe asanaya pipase तीर्त्वा अतिक्रम्या शोकमतीत्य गच्छतीति शोकातिगस्सम् मानसेन दुःखेन वर्जितः मोदते हृष्यति स्वर्गलोके दिव्ये किञ्च इन एडिशन टू दैट उभे अशनाया पिपासे बोथ thirst and hunger, both hunger and thirst in that order. Tiyartva means having crossed atikramya, means he will not be suffering from them. Shoka atigaha is the word. Shokam atitya gachyati, that is the samasa. Shoka atigaha. Shokam means manasika dukkham. Atitya means atikramya. Gachyati means goes. Goes means what? He moves here and there without any manasika dukkham ityartha. So the idea is manasena dukkhena varjitaha. He is totally away from mental illness or mental problems. So jara is not there, asanaya is not there, pipasa is not there, manasika dukkham is not there, mrityu bhayam is not there. What more you want? So the fellow is really happy. That's why modate, hrushyati, where? Svargaloke, means dyuloke, dyulokam. That Vedic name for this svargaloka. Even this svarga itself is a Vedic name only. That's why Bhaskara is used the word divye. Divye means dyuloke chattaha. So, in this mantra, having gained the first varam of Pitru Saumanasyam, Nachiketa is trying to take the second varam of Agni Vidya. For that, he is preparing the ground. That is the mantra. Very interesting mantra. Then now he is really asking a prashna. Here, prashna and varam are used synonymously. Prashna is not something different and varam is not different. Because Trin Varan Vrunishva, that is what Yama told. And Nachiketa asks a question in response to that. Therefore, the question is answered by Yama. By the time the question is answered, the question is asked, so it is equivalent to asking for a varam. The answer is given, it is equivalent to granting a varam. That is how it has to be understood. So, Agni Vishayaha Prashnaha, the question about Agni is being taken up in the 13th mantra. We will say mantram. सत्वमग्निगुस्वर्ग्यमध्येषु मृत्यो प्रब्रूहित्वग्श्रद्दधानाय मह्यम् स्वर्गलोका अमृतत्वं भजन्ते एतद्वितीयेन वृणे वरेण सत्वमग्निगुस्वर्ग्यम् अध्येषि मृत्यो प्रब्रूहित्वग्श्रद्दधानाय मह्यम स्वर्गलोका अमृतत्वं भजन्ते एतद्वितीयेन वृणेवरेण स्वसह त्वं अग्निं स्वर्ग्यं अध्येषि मृत्यो प्रब्रूहि त्वं श्रद्धधानाय मह्यं स्वर्गलोकाः अमृतत्वं भजन्ते एतत् द्वितीयेन वृणे वरेण. सी सपोज जेल सुपरिंटेंडेंट इज देयर. जेल सुपरिंटेंडेंट दो ही इज हिज पोस्ट ऑफ हिज एरिया ऑफ ऑपरेशन इज ए जेल. ही इज नॉट बाउंड इन द जेल लाइक ए क्रिमिनल. ही इज एन अथॉरिटी इन द जेल. So it is like any other government job. A lot of power and adhikara goes along with it. So similarly, Yamadharmaraja, he is the head of the Narakalokam. It doesn't mean that he also suffers along with all the fellows there. Though his post of operation is Narakaloka, he is as happy as any Swargaloka fellow. He is like any other government officer. Our jail superintendent is also as happy as any one of them. He gets equivalent salary, he gets other perks equal to all other officers. So similarly, Yama also is equivalent to like Indra, etc. So that way we have to understand, not that Yama is also suffering. So he says, Sahatvam agnim svargyam adhyeshi mrityo, he mrityo, you have studied that agni vidya, which gives us svargaloka. It is clear. It is like a jail superintendent. He must have studied some higher education and passed some exams. Then only he must have come to that occupy that post.